Hey folks, I am back again. Have you ever heard about a person who had almost failed in every invention he did and was deeply rooted in heavy debts? Probably not, right? And what about a person who failed almost in every invention, was in heavy debts, but eventually became a billionaire?
Yes.
And a sir. Yes, like a knight with a sword and everything. Well, I am happy if you didn't hear about this person, because then I would probably be jobless. No, I'm kidding. But guys, even if you did hear of him, keep watching. It'll be fun. Today, I am here with a renowned personality who faced a hard time experimenting with technology, but he became successful merely by collecting dust. Yes, you heard it right. Dust. 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 It's a cool word. Okay, I know, I sound like the confused wired guy. But let me tell you about the personality a little, and you will surely get the answers to your questions. And if you don't have any, you will just be amazed like I was when I found out. Oh, I'm getting excited for you! Our guy was born back in 1947. And basically, this dude created history with some cardboard and tape. He is an entrepreneur, an investor, an industrial designer, and above all, an interesting gentleman. From what I saw, this guy probably looked like the crazy guy trying to invent the next crazy machine. But let's check out how this person achieved so much. Success, honor, happiness, and not less important, a ton of money. Like, I am talking about a lot of money. But we know that money is not the most important thing. You know that, right? Okay, let's move on. Our interesting gentleman was born into a middle-class family. He was a child who wanted to explore the countryside, the seaside, the sand dunes, and freedom in his youth. Unlike my kid, who just wants to explore Fortnite, GTA, and the wonders of Minecraft, which is cool, I can't deny, but come on, go outside and explore some stuff. Build stuff in real life like you do on Minecraft. See the difference? Anyway, our inventor and an industrial designer was then a student at an art college, where he got his motivation to go into products design. Unlike him, I'm still looking for someone or something to influence me. Let's see when that'll happen. Then you guys are going to showcase a video about my inventions! Our little inventor got his first designing assignment while he was studying at college. He helped in designing a sea truck. This is his collaborative design effort. He even invented the ball barrow. Yes, you heard it right. Not a wheelbarrow, a ball barrow is what makes him famous. Well, not exactly the kind of famous we are talking about, and that he will reach soon, but still pretty cool. His creative mind makes him think about problems in a different way, and more about the way he wants to solve them. For example, with the ball barrow, he thought about entrenching in mud, and it was solved with the invention of the ball barrow. But it was a short-term success. Soon, he lost his position in the company to investors due to a shortage of money. They literally kicked him out of the board. I am also in need of money, but nobody listens to me. I know you guys are listening to me. Nah, I don't really need your money. At least go bring me a sandwich. All this talking about the ball barrow made me think about hard work, and that made me hungry. Now let's get back to our inventor. Let's see how he kicked back his way to the top. He struck back with his inventor mind and created the most successful product that brought him fame and money. A lot.
Yes.
It's a bagless vacuum cleaner. This product cleared his way to becoming a billionaire. And you know the most exciting part? He is the person who doesn't want it. All he likes is inventing stuff, making things work better. That's why he keeps on inventing new products. Some of them failed. But nothing stops this guy. To remind you, he had a lot of failures and a lot of no's from investors, manufacturing companies, and people along his way. The part that I absolutely love and admire, and I am sure you will too, is that he thought about his big vacuum invention at the age of 23, but only 23 years later at the age of 46. And 5,127 prototypes, he launched the first model. Wow! This guy just don't know how to give up. Amazing! But hear that? All the manufacturers in his country rejected him. Not one wanted to partner with him. Suckers! Excuse me for my language. I just got excited because I know the end of this story. Yeah, you want me to get to the reveal. Just be patient. So, after he started selling his product in Japan and won some prizes there, he decided to set up his own manufacturing company and sell his own inventions, not owing to anybody. His other inventions, such as hair dryers, heaters, and lighting, brought him great success too. Some are quite successful and out of this world, while some, like washing machines, are a failure, and they are really out of this world now, like literally. Our inventor believes in keeping on inventing, as he had a bug of creativity inside him. He is a great salesman too, and a pretty genius marketer. Now, he is a billionaire because he knows when to kickstart the market, and with what the markets need. He finds a problem, an existing solution, and makes it much better. That's why his bagless vacuum cleaner, although it costs 3 times more than a normal one, is a great success. Amazing this about our guy here is that he created platforms for young engineers to let them explore the world of inventions as well.
Yes.
He even formed an Institute of Engineering to offer engineering degrees to aspirants. I hope by now you have guessed the great entrepreneur. You must have guessed his famous brand of vacuum cleaner also. I mean, come on, think. What is the most known vacuum cleaner today? What every person wants to clean his home? What is the iPhone of the vacuum cleaners? That last one was good, right? Yeah, you got it right. I am talking about the famous Sir James Dyson, whose Dyson vacuums are a great hit. You must have taken inspiration from his life journey and the struggles he faced, and if not, watch this again. I mean, this dude officially started his success at the age of 46, after countless of ups and downs, just without the ups part. So, just for you to know, James Dyson's net worth today is around $9.7 billion. Wow. His company Dyson employs more than 5,800 engineers around the world and says it invests about $10 million a week in product development. That is pretty awesome. I invest $100 a week in snacks and coffee from Starbucks. Yeah, not the same. I have a problem. I love iced coffee. Leave me alone. So that's all for today. I will check you people out with a new and interesting story about an interesting personality. Till then, keep watching our channel and don't forget to like the video. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please subscribe. Money is not important to Sir James Dyson, so go do amazing stuff and never give up. Okay, guys, see you soon. Bye for now.
Hey, did you bring me the sandwich I asked?
Yes.